Hi, my name is Hooft. In this short video, I will show you how to determine the absolute configuration of a refined X-ray structure using our Bayesian method. The video will be based on the implementation in PLATON. We start by loading the structure from a SIF or shell XRES file into PLATON. Structure factors must be available as well. They will be loaded by PLATON automatically from an FCF file or shellx.hkl. The example in this video is based on a structure determination of ammonium bitartrate. This structure contains oxygen atoms as the heaviest anomalous scatterers. In the main menu of PLATON, we click on the Bayesian pair analysis. The screen now shows the result of several different analyses of the absolute structure. If the SIF file that was loaded contains a flag parameter, it will be shown with its standard uncertainty at the top right of the screen. This structure obviously has not been determined accurately enough to make an assignment based on the flag parameter. The standard uncertainty is too high. What we are interested in here are the values below the flag parameter in the rest of the right-hand column. In the measured data set, there are 612 observed Bayesian pairs, a completeness of 100%. PLATON shows the size of the observed Bayesian differences and a comparison with the calculated values in the scatter plot at the left. We will not go into details to explain this graph here. At the bottom of the result column, you will find the Bayesian statistics. Which of the given values is the most important to you depends on what you know about your sample. If you know that your sample is one pure enantiomer, the most interesting values to look at are the P2 values. PLATON calculates P2 true, which is a probability that the absolute structure of the model is correct, given the prior knowledge that it must be one or the other of the enantiomers. If it is possible that the crystal is a one-to-one racemic twin, the most interesting values are the P3 values. In this case, P3 true gives the probability that the absolute structure of the crystal is properly described. P3 false gives the probability that the inverted absolute structure is right. And P3 racemic twin gives the probability of the one-to-one racemic twin being the right model. Sometimes PLATON will not calculate the P2 and P3 values. This will happen when PLATON detects that it's very unlikely that the structure is indeed a pure enantiomer or a one-to-one racemic twin. In case you want to consider racemic twin at all ratios, the most interesting value is the Y parameter listed at the bottom. This value and its standard deviation can be used the same way as you would use the flag X parameter. In general, you will see that the standard uncertainty in the Y parameter will be significantly lower than the uncertainty in the flag X parameter, and therefore it will be easier to assign the absolute structure for a structure with only light atoms. For this structure of ammonium bitartrate, all indications are that the refined model is the wrong model and that the structure should be inverted.